Welcome everybody. Welcome to your first lesson of Italian language level 1. Today we will start with lesson number 1 and I will try to concentrate one lesson in within 15 minutes, so I don't want to use too much of your time. Italian language, just for introduction today, is maybe something new for you, because is a language that different from English and different also from Bahasa Malaysia, because in Italian you will see nouns, adjectives that got some peculiarities. I refer to the what we call genders. Every noun, every adjective can be masculine or can be feminine according to the gender of the item itself. But before going deeply into the gender and to how to understand if one thing is masculine or feminine, for the lesson number one, I would like to draw your attention to our alphabet. The Italian alphabet. I will write it here. Alfabeto, that means alphabet. So I want you to repeat after me the how we pronounce the single words. The Italian alfabeto has 21 words, exactly 21 words. So I will write it down here, and after I will pronounce, you repeat after me. Okay, the first letter is letter A. Pronounce after me, A. After that we write letter B. You pronounce B. Letter number 3, we pronounce C. Pronounce after me, C. Number 4, D. Pronounce after me, D. Number 5, A. Pronounce after me, A. F. Pronounce after me, F. G. H. I. L. M. N. O. P. Q. R. S. T. U. V. Z. These are the Italian alphabet. As you can see, we don't use some letters that you will use in English or in other languages, such as the letter J. No Italian words you will find with J, or the word K, or the word Y. Okay, or the word X as well. You will never find any word using this word. What I would like to draw your attention is especially on the letter, the number one, that you have to pronounce A. so not like in English A, but just A. Another word that you have to remember is this one. You pronounce A, not like in English. This one in English would be E, but you have to pronounce A. Another word that you have to remember is this one. You don't have to pronounce I, but you have to pronounce E. For the rest, is almost the same. O, U, P, M, C, D, A, E. This is what is important to remember. So after talking about the Italian alphabet, let's go back to where we were talking before during the introduction. So the gender. So every item, everything can be categorized as masculine or feminine. And how to understand if it's if something belongs to the masculine gender or to the feminine gender. Actually, it's very easy. There is one rule that is very simple that if you concentrate on this rule, you will not have any problem to understand. When you see an Italian word, I cancel this letter because we will never use anyway. When you meet an Italian word, imagine you open a dictionary and you want to find out how to say book, for example, you will find on the dictionary this word, libro. Libro means book. Now, to understand if the word libro belongs to the masculine or to the feminine gender, you always have to look to the last letter. In this case, the last letter is O. So, 99% of the time, if the word ends in O, the word that you have in front of you is masculine. Imagine you open the dictionary and you want to find out how to say house. On the dictionary you will find this word, casa. Casa means home. As you notice on the word casa, the last word now is not O, but is A. A. So, again, 99% of the time, if the last letter is A, the name, the Italian name that you are going to use belongs to the feminine gender. If the last word is O, the gender is masculine. This is the most common rule. 99% of the time it will be like that. For example, let's make a few examples just to make it easier. Let's say I want to find out how to say pen, the pen that I'm using now. On the dictionary, I will find this word, penna. Penna means pen. As you notice, the last letter is A again. So, the gender, the name, penna, is a feminine name. The gender is feminine. Imagine you want to know how to say this item that will be very important for our lesson because we'll use a lot, the duster, to erase our word. And in the dictionary, you will find this word, let's pronounce together. Cancellino, cancellino. Cancellino is the duster, so something that we use in class. Okay, the last letter, as you can see, is O. So, if the word is, if the last letter is O, it means that the Italian word that you are going to use is masculine. This is the general rule that you will have to know. So every word, every adjective as well, as we will see in the other lesson, can be or masculine or feminine. The first rule that you have to remember, you always have to look to the last letter. If the last letter is O, it means the word that you met, that you're going to use, is masculine. If the last letter is A, like casa or like penna, it means the word is feminine. Word like libro or cancellino, the last word is O, it means the word is masculine. I don't want to keep you any longer for lesson number one. So I think that this is the end of lesson number one. I will meet you again in the lesson number two to continue about talking about Italian language level one. I'll see you again.